Hi, I'm Jacqueline Primrose Monahan, and we're here with Between Two Urns, where we focus on raising our consciousness. Now, I would like to start with a moment where we hold hands and together think about us all being one. Okay, we're here with Madeleine Olnek, my great aunt Jessica, and my newly parted dad.
Departed.
Oh.
Good afternoon.
Frank. That's me, Frank. Sorry. Nice to meet you. Go ahead, hon. Do your thing.
She might not be like to be referred as hun, Frank.
Well,
Nobody likes to be called hun. Hi, Madeleine.
Hi.
So you're promoting your movie, Wild Nights with Emily.
Yes, the movie was nominated for the John Cassavetes Independent Spirit Award. It's being released by Universal on DVD and Amazon Prime and iTunes, etc. on February 11th.
Great.
Who's in it? Who's in your movie?
Oh. Well, Molly Shannon
I love her.
plays Emily Dickinson, and also Jackie Monahan's in it.
Oh.
Wow.
I heard she's pretty good.
She is.
She's a national treasure?
Yes.
Okay. Is that what people have been saying? National treasure?
Okay. Quit while you're ahead, hon. You're in a movie. Good for you. What's it about again?
It's Wild Nights with Emily. My movie is the story of the hidden life of Emily Dickinson, which is really the opposite of what everyone thought it was.
How was it different? Was it like Avatar? Is your movie like Avatar?
Wait, well, what I want to talk about is love. Like, where is love expanding? That's my...
Okay, well, there's lots of love in the movie.
Wait, not romantic love.
Why don't you let her finish? Where does everybody get off jumping down my throat because I used hun? It's a term of endearment, by the way. I didn't mean anything by it, but, you know, shoot me. And now, hey, let's go trample on
Emily
Dickinson's grave. That's great. You know, everybody, have at it, ladies.
Hey, it's diminutive and it's sexist, and I think it's inappropriate, especially when we're talking about Emily Dickinson.
What, is she Mother Teresa? She's something special? Because she wrote a book?
She actually didn't write a book. She was a poet.
Yeah, there it is.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I can't write a whole book.
Poetry.
I can write a whole one page.
We're off the topic. This show is all about raising the consciousness. And I believe Madeleine does a good job of raising the consciousness of the world through her films, through love and laughter. In what way do you feel that the movie has expanded the consciousness of the world?
Well, I think it's a completely unknown piece of women's history. And we worked really hard to capture Emily Dickinson's story in a way that's historically based.
You know, I had to say one.
Wait, time out. You're calling it Wild Nights with Emily? You're kind of like pissing on her grave, right? Making her out to be some kind of loosey-goosey weirdo chick?
She did write a poem called Wild Nights, so... It wasn't pissing on her, to quote. And what's so amazing about Dickinson's poetry is that even though it was written in the 1800s, it's so contemporary. That's one of the things that was so surprising to me. So we tried to include the poems in the movie for the audience to have experiences.
Did you ever think to yourself, hey, a movie about poems, that's a great way to bore the shit out of people?
Okay. When we expand the world, it's never boring. It's always rewarding. You know, the only reason you don't find it rewarding, Dad, is because you're not really doing it. You're not allowing it to make you...
No, I'm sorry. I want to spend $15 to go into a movie. I don't want to fall asleep. Maybe you put it like a car crash or like a gun scene.
Well, I do want to say that when we showed the movie at the Sarasota Film Festival... senior citizens really loved it, and among their universal praise for the film, I often heard, I didn't fall asleep once.
See?
That's a lot for a movie to make someone who's 95.
Sarasota!
Yeah, Sarasota.
Wow!
That's where the
they have a horse and trolley race there.
It is where you get the finest. I'm saying
viewings of Cocoon.
Okay, we can cut.